हेलो एवरीवन, मेरा नाम है पवन असावा और हमारी यूट्यूब चैनल पीएलसी टेक वर्ल्ड में आपका एक बार फिर से स्वागत है। तो जैसा कि आपको पता होना चाहिए कि ये जो हमारा यूट्यूब चैनल है पीएलसी टेक वर्ल्ड, इस पर हम इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन फील्ड के जो भी वीडियोज होते हैं या फिर नॉलेज होती है उसे आपके साथ शेयर करते हैं। तो इस वीडियो में हम समझेंगे इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन फील्ड में पूछे जाने वाले इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस के बारे में। इसके अलावा अगर आप इंटरव्यू की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन फील्ड में जॉब को पाना चाहते हैं, तो इस वीडियो को पूरा देखें। इसके अलावा ये जो हमारी प्लेलिस्ट है इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन फील्ड इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस, इस प्लेलिस्ट के और भी वीडियोज आप लोग देख सकते हैं। इसके अलावा अगर आप ऑनलाइन पीएलसी या फिर एचएमआई सीखना चाहते हैं तो हमसे कांटेक्ट कर सकते हैं। तो आइए वीडियो को स्टार्ट करते हैं।
इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चंस। व्हाट इज ऑटोमेशन? ऑटोमेशन, रोबोटाइजेशन और इंडस्ट्रियल ऑटोमेशन इज द यूज ऑफ कंट्रोल सिस्टम्स सच एज कंप्यूटर्स, पीएलसी, सीएनसी, पीआईडीज एक्सेट्रा टू कंट्रोल इंडस्ट्रियल मशीनरी एंड प्रोसेसेस। इट इज टू रिड्यूस नीड फॉर ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशन। A delegation of human control functions to industrial machineries and equipments for increasing productivity, quality, safe working conditions, and to reduce production cost. Question number 2. What are different components used in automation? Answer is, the different components of automation system are 1. Sensors for sensing the input parameters like limit switches, position sensors. 2. Transmitters for transmitting the raw physical signal in electrical signals form. 3. Control system, which includes PLC, DCS and PID controllers. 4. Output devices, actuators like drives, control valves. Question number 3. What are different control systems used in automation? Answer is, different control systems used in automation are 1. PID controller based control system. 2. PLC based control system. 3. DCS based control system. 4. PC based automation system. 5. CNC based control system. Question number 4. Explain PID based control system. Answer is, PID, abbreviated as proportional integral derivative, is the algorithm widely used in closed loop control systems. The PID controller takes care of closed loop control systems in plant. PID controllers are widely used for independent control loops. Question number 5. What is difference between PLC and relay? Answer is, 1. PLC is a programmable hardware, whereas relay is not a programmable device. 2. PLC can work for both digital and analog IOs, whereas a relay cannot. 3. PLC is much more advanced as compared to relay. Question number 6. What is the difference between DCS and PLC? Answer. DCS refers to a control system, usually of a manufacturing system, process, or any kind of dynamic system, in which the controller elements are not central in location, like the brain, but are distributed throughout the system. The entire system of controllers is connected by a network for communication and monitoring. DCS is a very broad term used in a variety of industries to monitor and control distributed equipment. DCS are used to control the entire plant and a process. PLC. In PLC, programmable logic controllers, based system, the system has processor and IOs and some functional units like basic modules and so on. PLC are usually used for particular machine automation. Question number 7. What is encoder? Answer. An electronic encoder is a sensor or transducer for converting rotary motion or position to a series of electronic pulses. An encoder is a rotary device that outputs digital pulses which correspond to incremental angular motion. Question number 8. What types of sensors are used for measuring different parameters? Answer. 1. Temperature sensors, RTD, thermocouple, thermistor. 2. Pressure sensor, Bowden tube, bellows, strain gauge. 3. Flow sensors, pitot tube, rotameter. 4. Level sensors, level switches, optical level sensors, ultrasonic level sensor, etc. 5. Position sensors, proximity switches, etc. Question number 9. What is transmitter? Answer. The sensor measures a physical variable, such as temperature or pressure, and outputs a very low-level electronic signal. The basic function of the transmitter is to amplify it to a higher-level electrical signal and send that signal a long distance to a control or readout device. Typically, the output from the transmitter is 4 to 20 milliampere and 0 to 10 volt DC. Question number 10. Why is 4 to 20 milliampere signal preferred over 0 to 10 volt signal? Answer. The 0 to 10 volt signal has a tendency to drop because of line resistance over long distance transmissions. As we know that resistance of a conductor is directly proportional to length. Therefore, the 0 to 10 volt signal received at the controller will not be accurate. The 4 to 20 milliampere signal will travel a long distance without dropping signal value. Question number 11. Why is 4 to 20 milliampere preferred over 0 to 20 milliampere signal? Answer. With 0 to 20 milliampere, you cannot distinguish between the minimum field value and a connection break. With 4 to 20 milliampere, the internal circuit can distinguish between a connection break and the minimum value. Normally, when the value is minimum, the transmitter will give you 4 milliampere, while in the case of a connection break, it will give 0 milliampere. Please subscribe our channel for more industrial knowledge.